Good evening, Titans. This is Mr. Sturtz. We are on Lesson 3.6, Part 2. Before we had translations and reflections, tonight we're going to have stretches and shrinks. Moving into our core concept, horizontal stretches and shrinks. Okay, and what this means, focus on this right here. We have y equals f of a times x. If we have a number being multiplied in the middle of our function there, we know it's going to be a horizontal stretch or shrink. And this, the y-intercept stays the same. So if that number being multiplied to x is greater than 1, we're going to have what we call a horizontal shrink, and it shrinks towards our y-axis. If that number is between 0 and 1, it's going to be what we call a horizontal stretch, which means it stretches away from our y-axis. Moving to vertical stretches and shrinks, if we have a number being multiplied to our whole function, it's a vertical stretch or shrink. And on these, the x-intercept stays the same. If the number being multiplied is greater than 1, we have what we call a vertical stretch. It stretches away from the x-axis. If it's between 0 and 1, we have a vertical shrink, which means it shrinks towards our x-axis. All right, our first example here, our parent function, or our original function, is f of x equals x minus 1. We need to graph, let's graph part A first, g of x equals f times 1/3 x. Okay, so how we're going to go about this is we're going to make a table. All right, just like our last, the part one of this section, we're going to make a table. We're going to have some x values. We're going to have a 1/3, excuse me there, 1/3 of x. And we're going to have f of 1/3 of x. Okay, we're going to complete our table here. We're going to plug in a couple values. We're going to plug in, for this example, negative 3, 0, and 3. Now, 1/3 of x, of our original number there. So 1/3 of negative 3, we get a negative 1. 1/3 of 0 is 0, and 1/3 of 3 is 1. Now, our function says 1/3 of x, f of 1/3 of x. So what we're going to do is we're going to plug that back into our original function here. So negative 1 minus 1 is a negative 2. Negative 1, or sorry, 0 minus 1 is a negative 1. And 1 minus 1 is 0. Okay, now let's graph. Okay, we want to see what this transformation does. Okay, if we graph our original function, x minus 1, we know our y-intercept's at negative 1, so we're going to plot our point. And our slope, if there's no number before x, we know it's going to be 1. So we're going to go up 1, right 1, plot a point. And we're going to go up 1 more, right 1, plot a point. Okay, if we connect our dots there, we have our line. Now, to figure out this translation, we're going to graph the ordered pair x and f of 1/3 x. So we're going to graph our top numbers, and our y-coordinates are going to be our bottom numbers. So that first ordered pair is negative 3, negative 1, 2, 3, negative 2. So we plot a point here. Our second point is going to be 0, negative 1. Okay, remember, that y-intercept doesn't change on these. And then our last point is 3, 1, 2, 3, 0. So if we connect these points, we can see here that we have a horizontal stretch because it stretches away from our y-axis. That line stretches away from our y-axis. Like we said before, that number being multiplied by x is between 0 and 1, so we're going to have a horizontal stretch. And that's our part A. Let's get this erased. And we're going to work on part B here. Okay, now part B says h of x equals 3 times f of x. Okay, so again, let's make our table. Okay, we're going to always start by making our table here. We're going to have x, we're going to have f of x, and we're going to have 3 times f of x. Now, we have a number being multiplied by our function. Okay, so like we said before, we know it's going to be a vertical, either stretch or shrink. If we plug in numbers, let's plug in 0, 1, and 2 for this example, and plug these into our original function for f of x. So if we plug in 0, we get a negative 1. If we plug in 1, we get 1 minus 1 is 0. And if we plug in 2, we get 2 minus 1 is 1. Now, 3 times this second number. So we have 3 times negative 1 is negative 3. 3 times 0 is 0. 3 times 1 is 3. And let's graph. Again, let's graph our original function, which is x minus 1. So we'll go down to the y-axis, plot a point. Our slope is still 1, up 1, right 1. Let's go up 1, right 1 again. Plot another point, connect our lines. And it's a vertical, so let's go ahead and graph our ordered pairs here. Again, we're going to use the top and the bottom. So 0, negative 3, 0, negative 1, 2, 3, plot a point. 1, 0. Since it's vertical, our x coordinate does not move. Okay, and then 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. Let's go up here. Connect our points. Now notice here we have a vertical stretch. Okay, it's actually a vertical stretch by 3 because 3 is what we're multiplying to our function. So it stretches away from our x-axis.